Hi guys, I am back. And so today we're going to be talking about when the devil gets busy and how to stay calm. Boy, oh boy, do we know the devil can get busy at any time and anywhere. On your job, at home, in these stores. Come on, even when you're sleeping, honey. Even when you're sleeping, he'll try to disturb that sleep so you won't have energy to do the right thing and stay calm. So I just want to give you some tips on how to stay calm when the devil gets busy. Come on. And one of them is, you know, repeating the word back to yourself in your mind, you know, saying that it is written. Amen. It is written in the word of God that I shall have peace that surpasses all understanding. Hallelujah. Also, I have like some protones that go around my neck, which is basically like a wireless, you know, speaker to where I can hear music or, you know, YouTube videos. If you have that, you need to have that at all times. If you have a problem with staying calm, I feel like you need to have that at all times. And if you're at work, you know, I would wear an earpiece that can fit right in your ear. And for the ladies, ladies only, sorry, fellas, that also can be covered up just like this. It can be covered up just like that. So nobody at work knows that you have something in your ear that is helping you to stay calm. You know, you can also have videos saved on YouTube in your library, entitled it Funny Stuff. You know, that's what I do. And I have Marcus D. Wiley in there, Bathtubs and Bibles. That's the name of his comedic set, and it is funny. Let me tell you, it is so funny. You can't stay mad for too long if you're listening to that. Amen, somebody. Also, relax and drop your shoulders. Relax and drop your shoulders. You know, bring your shoulders down. I just want to demonstrate that to you. Bring them down. You know, don't have them so tensed up. You know, try not to let your body tense up. I know it's hard, but it's going to take practice. And later in this message, I'm going to give you some things that can help you with that. When your body tenses up and, you know, your shoulders tense up, you can't think quickly about how to keep the situation from escalating. You know, we don't want to escalate. We want to de-escalate. Amen. Keep your voice calm and at an even tone. You know, you can't let these people know that they're getting under your skin. You know, that's what they want. Don't give them that satisfaction. Remember, your anger is expensive. You know, they just don't deserve that. The another point is, everything doesn't have to be a fight. If your friend breaks your vase, just buy a new one. Who cares? Who cares? You know, life is just too short. The next tip I wanted to give is accept people for who they are. Accept people for who they are and how they are. And accept the situation for what it is. You know, you don't have to think it should be different, you know, at any time. It's okay to leave that store. Amen. It's okay to go to another CVS and find that product if the person at the current CVS is not helping you. You know, and it's okay to surrender all to Christ, even God's people, even the situation. You can just say, hey, I'm going to pull out and go to another store to get what I need. You know, I'm not getting what I need here. And surrender it to God. Pray for God's people. Pray for them. Pray that they're blessed, you know. Not that they'll change. Just pray that they're blessed and move on with your day. Amen. You can pick your favorite person that you have in your life and keep a picture of them in your purse or in your wallet. So when things get haywire on the job or in these stores, you can step away. Say, excuse me, I need to go to the restroom and pull that out. Or excuse me, I'm going to go to the restroom. You can say a quick prayer in the restroom or do those breathing exercises that I taught you in another video or the chest tapping that I taught you in another video to calm down. Also, you know, I keep some lavender oil in my purse, you know, and I keep tissue in my purse. So, you know, I can step away. Excuse me, I need to go to the restroom. And, you know, I could just use that lavender oil on a piece of tissue and just smell that. And that'll instantly calm you down. You know, and like I said, you can do the breathing techniques and also progressive muscle relaxation. They have that on YouTube and on Google. You can just look that up. Also, if you're in the store and the salesperson makes you mad, like I said, just leave and find it somewhere else. If they're doing a lot, just leave it alone. You know, I've mentioned that, but that's such an important point to just, you know, go over. You know, you can't change people. You're powerless against other people. And make sure that you're not thirsty or hungry. You know, you're going all day and not eating, and then you're trying to go to 5 different stores, you know, to go shopping. You're just not going to have the energy or the patience to get through a day like that without eating. And so now I want to give you some scriptures on peace. And so the first one is John 16:33. These things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Amen, somebody. The second one is John 14:27. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Amen. Amen. The third one I want to give to you is Isaiah 26:3. You will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you. Hallelujah. The word doesn't come back void. Amen, somebody. You will have peace if the Bible says so. Amen. You know, and you can also use these techniques that I'm giving you to maintain and keep your peace. You're on God's assignment. Wherever you go, at your home, with your spouse, with your boyfriend, with your girlfriend, on your job, even virtually, you are on God's assignment. In these stores, in these restaurants, you're God's child. And sometimes it gets hard to show godly love to God's children. Amen. But we know that we have the fruit of the Spirit, and that's self-control. Amen. And so we have to handle God's people with godly love. And it's okay at the end of the day to do that, no matter how badly they're misbehaving or behaving. Amen. We're still going to bless them. So I just wanted to give you this quick word. Amen. It hit my spirit so hard, I had to stop my car and pull over and record. Amen. I love you guys. Keep sending the comments. Keep sending the email. I always leave my email in the description box. I love hearing your testimonies about how God has given me this knowledge and now is helping you, people all across the United States of America. Okay. Bye, guys. Love you. Bye.